Hello, my little earthlings. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking to you guys about why you should make a soundtrack for your webcomic. So what do I mean when I say make a soundtrack for your webcomic? Some people, they just like to do this in their head. Some people like to curate a playlist on YouTube or Spotify. But what I mean is every time you're working on your webcomic, first of all, think about the genre of the webcomic you're doing. So for example, with my comic, it is a sci-fi action romance. So all of the music that I like to make sure that I curate for my webcomic is basically stuff that falls into that kind of sci-fi or romantic feel, stuff that maybe feels kind of epic. And don't be afraid to put other soundtrack music from other people that you like. I personally really like Dan Romer. I find his stuff to be really good, along with Craig Armstrong. Both of them, I feel, very much encapsulate the epic overarching feeling that I want for ET Girl. So therefore, those are the ones that I typically like to use. And then I like to sprinkle in a bunch of other indie artists and things like that, that I just feel like I think of ET Girl when I hear them. So why is this important, you might ask? It holds a lot more importance to it than you think. First of all, it is fun, and it's always good to associate fun with your webcomic, especially if you're doing it as a full-time thing for yourself and you're not making any money on it yet. You want to try to make the process as fun as possible. Remember, it's all about the journey. It's not about the end result. So just in case this comic that you're working on never really takes off in the way that it's making you big money, so you don't have to worry about anything else, at least you're having fun along the way. And being able to build a soundtrack for your webcomic can help bring it to life in that way that will give you that. It also helps you sort of project in the future, and you can imagine sort of like your webcomic if it got an adaptation into a movie. So it gives you kind of like this long striving goal. I wouldn't say don't get attached to the idea of being like, well, I'm going to make a soundtrack because I want to guarantee that my webcomic's going to get picked up and made into a show. That will set you up for like failure for sure. But if you go into it thinking, how cool would it be, or how fun would it be, or if my webcomic was a TV show or movie, what music would I want to have in the background if I got to be the one who had the creative control over that project? So that's why I say use it. Use it kind of, like I said, like something to make it fun for you. So how this can really also help your creative process is it has something to do with something I learned in psychology called classical conditioning. So the concept here would be, if you're having a really hard time trying to sit and focus on working on your webcomic, if you create an association in your brain every time you listen to these particular songs that you have, every time you listen to them, you're typically working on your webcomic. Say like you just carve out 30 minutes a day or something and you're sitting and working on your webcomic and you always have that music playing on Spotify or YouTube or something in the background, you're conditioning your brain. So every time you hear that music, your brain goes, okay, it's time to work on my comic. So this can really help you because it can kind of override that feeling of like, I don't feel in the mood to work on my comic, or I don't really have any inspiration, or I'm getting artist block. I've noticed a lot whenever I use my soundtrack, it really helps break through my artist block, or at least I can tell myself, well, I'll just work on my comic for one or two songs and I'll see how I feel. You know, I just gotta play one or two songs that are on my playlist. So yeah, so help create that, use a little bit of science and help create that classical conditioning in your brain so you know that you can turn to this thing that you're already associating with fun. Because typically, remember, as human beings, the only time we want to do anything or put any effort into something is when we feel we're having fun with it. And so the best way to do that is just make sure you're making the process fun along the way, because that's ultimately your responsibility more than anything else. You know, blaming the comic or blaming, you know, life circumstances being hard on why you can't work on your dreams won't help you. But being able to take responsibility and be like, how do I make this fun for myself so I can make sure I enjoy the process along the way? That's what's really important. So I highly, highly recommend that you work on a soundtrack for your webcomic. And, you know, down in the comments below, I would be really interested in knowing, first of all, if I'm the only person who does this when I work on a webcomic. If you work on a webcomic, I would love to know, like, I'd like for you to write like a little blurb about your webcomic. And then also, like, You can link to your playlist or something like that, because I'd love to see if I can feel like I get a feel for your webcomic when I listen to the playlist that you curate for it. I've only ever found one other person who really did this, and it was Jubilations. She did it. She made Desi, one of her characters that she had on DeviantArt. She made him a playlist, which I thought was really interesting. And I remember the first time I heard it, the music did not remind me of Desi for whatever reason. It was very dancey music, and yeah, it was kind of like very provocative, which was very much his character. But I remember being a little bit surprised when I listened to it, and I was like, oh, this didn't quite remind me of Desi. So you can also really get into the artist's head by doing that. And so that's why I would really love to hear if you guys have done this, or if you think it's a cool idea, and you end up making one, yeah, go ahead and share it with me. I would love to check it out. So if you want to find my playlist personally, I have one on Spotify called ET Girl. And I also have one here on YouTube. It should be in the playlist section on my channel here if you want to check it out. I'll put it at the end of the video. So you can get an idea of what I use for ET Girl. Sometimes on my Instagram as well, when I'm working on a story for Instagram, that's a great place to be able to insert 15 seconds of a song that I feel is part of my ET Girl soundtrack to help bring that to life. And you can do that with your audience too. I think it's a great way to use music and networking and all that to help promote your webcomic and give people more of a dynamic, dimensional, just three-dimensional kind of feel, so it doesn't feel so flat. It brings it to life. So if you like this video, please feel free to check out my other videos talking about web comics and tutorials. And if you want to see more things like this, just let me know. I'm always open to suggestions for topics. Always looking for new advice and things like that. I do have quite a long list of more things to come. So if you like this one, feel free to tune in for more down the road. And I will see you guys next time.